One is perceptibility, second is empiricism. I am seeing these things. Okay, 25% given. I am experiencing the benefits, 25% given. If 25, 50% is given, other 50% you need not experiment at all. You can just understand by means of logical inference. So this is what we have made, the clear-cut logical inference, that we can have perceptibility, number one. You have to classify all the way into three portions. Perceptible portion, empirical portion, and portions which are guided by experiential study or logical inference. So you classify all of these things. If you are strong and solid in these two areas, you can easily govern any rationalist at any area by that. It is possible. Then coming to treatment. Treatment, as you see, there is some common ethical problems with all people, whether it is homeopathy, allopathy, radioesthesia, then magnetotherapy, crystal healing, whatever it may be. There are some hurdles. One is mistake of conception. Second is mistake of dialysis or diagnosis. The third thing is aimless scrutiny or aimless never-ending journey of research. People will be doing lot of research. Now they told that it was cell, then they told it was genes. What is going on like that? You have to mute your gene and get the benefit. So it is going on like that without any end at all. So the first problem is misconception. Second is problem in diagnosis. The third thing is aimless, endless, directionless scrutiny or research that you are doing. Fourth thing is, now we are beating a lot of other fake medicines, duplicated medicines. Fifth thing is dangerous medicines. Most of the medicines are dangerous. They are drowsifiers and they are somnolizers. They are decapacitators of your physical strength and ability. Most of the medicines. That's why I told you in the seminar, empty means a mentor of dangers. Because each and every medicine that not only disturbs the disease and aggravates, creates also, invites also the sisters and brothers of the already existing diseases. That is the problem. And the other thing is fraudulent practice, unethical practice like organic trade and other things. And side effects. There is one more thing you have to understand, it is saturate efficacy. What is it? Saturate efficacy. If you take a medicine for 10 days, then afterwards it does not work. Then it will go against us even. That's why I told you in a pharmaceutical seminar, any medicine that is non-systematically, that is manufactured, that which is not a composite patient's product, it will come like a hero to safeguard you, it will become a comedian, will turn against you as a villain. So it will take the three musketeers dimension, it is known as saturant efficacy, whereby the medicines will not work out at all. And the final thing is cryptonymity. I don't know anything about the disease. World Health Organization and various other institutes, they have given a list of unidentifiable diseases and syndromes. Thousands of diseases, they are not identifiable, detectable, trackable, definable and curable. That is there. This thing is a common problem in all allopathy, homeopathy and other things along with Ayurveda, which we cannot work. Finally, I want to say two things. Number one is, whenever you are dealing with medicines, I want to give three solutions. One is, by application of bioinformatics. Second thing is transgenic confirmation of medical plans. Third thing is pharmacropping. I need that whenever there is possible, we can have a very great workshop in that with some more scholars. I deliver a lecture about pharmacropping and ICRISAT is interested in organizing a very big seminar at Bangalore, very big international seminar at Bangalore in the month of June in pharmacropping. What is bioinformatics? Most of the herbs mentioned in the Shastras, they are having a lot of problems. Number one, the same name is given to a lot of herbs. Different herbs have the same name. Number two, same herb, they have different names. Number three, the quality of the particular herb cannot be got similarly in all areas. Only some area has that potency. Fourth thing, the same herb has innumerable varieties and which to select, where to apply, we don't know about that. Number fifth thing, due to bio as well as geodegradation, they are not easily available, fully nutrient in nature. Fifth thing, they are not easily cultivable. Most of the things are growing, scarce, faded and put into obsoleteness. After 10 years, you will not get major proportions of the very famous drugs which we are going to use predominantly in drug manufacturing. These seven problems are there in the drug system, for which I want to mention bioinformatics. If you understand the protein sequence and proteinic expression of all of these things, we can create either identical boosting or parallel boosting or similar boosting of protein linked substances which can be used with bio-nanotechnology or biotechnology which can be used as medicines. Number one, transgenic plants. These plants, most of the plants which we are having now, they are not adaptable to any altitude, temperature, soil level, salinity, water level, humidity, etc. If they are made transgenic, they can be made into hyperactive, more productive, shorter in size, having more rotary cycles, acceptable to drought and overwater, having water retention, temperature retention, inbuilt pest resistance. Everything can be tuned inside by means of taking into a transgenic process. Third thing is farmer-cropping. Very wonderful thing. Nobody is interested. I have to just lament on myself. 100 square feet is more than enough to induce. For example, you take the micronutrient or protein level or the essential level of anything like Dithales omnivora. Induce it with Oryza sativa, that is rice. You mix it in the plant cell level or basic level, parental level, and create a sapling for that. Take a petri dish, cultivate and fuse them, both of them, and you create a new model, a new generation model. So this type of thing is known as farmer-cropping, which the world is now trying to understand. By making farmer-cropping, even a limited inducible element of these herbs can be mixed with wheat, barley, sesame, mustard, and other farmer consumables which we are normally using, that will create lot of other new revolutions in the herbal industry connected with food industry. So this is known as farmer-cropping. So somebody should, either I think that we should conduct a seminar on farmer-cropping, transgenic plants or transgenic systems to be inculcated or instilled in the herbal studies, as well as we have to understand about bioinformatics systems of protein multiplication, monitoring and simulation, and modeling of structures. Reflexive structures and reflective structures of these herbal plants. Other these things are done. I have already told about the trilateral combat of fuel, fundamental and food. That is herbs, the food consumption and fuel. We are not going to cultivate these things. Very difficult to adapt to last circumstances. We have to do this. Very essential. One more thing I want to say is, there are some four major disturbances with Ayurveda. It is treating with Loha, Dhatu, Rasa and Pashan. Rasa is Mercury, Dhatu is minerals and ores, and Loha are heavy metals, and Pashana is with toxins. And for that, what I want to say is, it is also a nanoprocessing. It is a process by which the functional structure, it is not a structural nanoprocessing like 10 to the power of minus 9 of a meter is a nanometer, what I told today. It is not like that. It is the functional nano engineering by which the energy of a particular element, three things is done. One, the mala, visha, and dauna bhaga, it is removed. Mala is the wastage, visha is the toxic thing, and third thing is dauna, the trivial things, they are released. Number two, the innate potency is revealed. The innate natural potency, losing the identity of ferrum, copperum, arginum, argentinum, all of these metals, they lose their structural identity and claim their functional identity. That is the second step. And first step, I already told, unwanted things are removed. Second thing, losing the identity, only wanted things are projected. Third thing, the projected energy is multiplied into billion times. That is known as calyx. Swarna basma or rajata basma, whatever it is multiplied, manifold, multifold, billion times it is multiplied. For that, unless you have two things, one is a certifier, second thing is a detector. By means of human perception of puta, then pakva, paripakva, sampakva, vivechana, shodhana, pariksha karana, niriksha,